The Model O and Model O Minus give you the ability to create macros and assign them to the buttons on the mouse. You can create macros using the Gloria software. A link will be included in the description. Start by launching the software. You should see a macro editor button on the left. Click on it. Create a new macro. Name your macro. You have the ability to record the events or insert them manually. I will be showing you how to do both. For this video, I will be creating a macro that saves a web page as a PDF. The script needed for this macro will be on screen. Start recording by pressing the button on the right. Input your script and the data will be recorded. Once you've finished, you can press stop to end your recording. You will notice arrows and timings associated with the entries. The arrows signify if the input is a press or release, and the numbers represent the delay between inputs. You can then double-click an event to change it. This allows you to reduce the delay and speed up tasks. To delete an event, you can select it and press delete on your keyboard, or use the button below. You can also insert an event via the drop-down menu in the bottom right. To add a new keyboard input, choose keystroke. A new window should open. Press the key of your choice, then click OK to confirm. Your new button will be added, with a press, release, and delay. There are also several options on the right that can be used to customize your macro. The cycle until key released option allows you to have your macro automatically repeat for as long as the button is held down. Once released, the macro will end. The cycle until any key pressed keeps the macro going until you've activated a different key. The final option allows you to set a specific amount of times you want the macro to repeat. By default, it is set to 1. Once you have finished your macro, close out of the editor. In the top left, you will see a table of buttons and their functions. If you want to set a macro to the left click, you will need to assign your click to a different button first. Choose the button that you want to assign your macro to and choose the macro option. Select the macro from the list and click OK to confirm. Press Apply to confirm your new settings. If you found this video helpful, then be sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe for more tech tips.